Hi, my name is Carlos Castillo. I work at the Qatar Computing Research Institute as a senior scientist. I'm going to talk to you about Aider. First, I'm going to show you a photo of Patrick right before a natural disaster. He's waiting for all the tweets to arrive. He's not wearing the hat, but it's him. We have observed up to 270 tweets per minute in some natural disasters, and this exceeds by far the capacity of humans to manage. Our objective is to try to sort these tweets into categories, into humanitarian clusters, into credibility levels, or into any arbitrary categories that you may think for this data. Now, if you want to classify 200 or more tweets per minute, the first thing you can do is to just work with the tweets that you can handle. But this forces you to ignore a lot of tweets and just is kind of running with your eyes closed. The second option you have is to try to get some lists of keywords and decide that, okay, certain keywords are going to separate things into one category or another. But this doesn't scale well, and many of you have actually tried to do it and noticed that it's not easy to do. Artificial intelligence is a very old computer science field. In one extreme, it has a lot of things that don't actually exist, like HAL 9000, Skynet, etc. And on the other hand, there are more modest areas that do exist, like supervised learning. In supervised learning, you take a small set of examples that have human-provided labels for them, and you do some machinery, and in the end, what you obtain is a classifier that automatically can sort out elements into different categories. In the case of Twitter, we do this through a couple of modules, a collector and a tagger. The collector gets data from Twitter, the tagger gets training examples, uses Weka, and classify things automatically. This is implemented in a platform called Aider that has several challenges. The first one is being effective and general, and the other is being easy to use. So this is one of our test users. She's very resistant to disruptive technologies. The platform that we have built is called Aider, Artificial Intelligence for Disaster Response. I have demonstrated the platform here, and you feel free to approach me at any time, and I will do a short demonstration for you. The platform is already available, and the URL is in some of the slides. Let me walk you through some of the screens. When you log in, you can go and create a new collection. A collection is basically a filter that runs over the Twitter API. You just put the keywords or the geographical region, and it starts collecting tweets from you. In this case, these are about the NSA scandal. This is if you want to add or change keywords at any time, the system keeps tab of what are the keywords you have used so that you have a collection that is reproducible and is well documented. After you build this collection, the next part starts, which is the interesting one, which is the tagger. In the tagger, you create a classifier, an automatic classifier that will have a list of categories, and you invite people through a public link to contribute to create this classifier. Additionally, you have the option of entering training data yourself. So if you can actually classify tweets yourself, and after you have classified perhaps 100 tweets or more, the system starts classifying on its own. This is the landing page that the volunteers see. This is a link that you can distribute to anyone, and it will allow the volunteers to click on that application and go to a crowdsourcing interface. And in this crowdsourcing interface, they are shown one tweet at a time and have to decide, okay, is this tweet belonging or not belonging to the categories you have defined? If you can define an arbitrary set of categories, they can be anything. So you will collect this data from the crowd, and the idea is that the system will learns using this data what are the keywords that are associated to one case of another. So for instance, PRISM is related to spying, but it's also related to Katy Perry because she has an album that is called PRISM. In our experiments, we have seen that we can scale up to 3 or 4 times the peak data observed historically, so we can handle maybe 500 or 700 tweets per minute at the same level of quality as usual. The output, you can export it in CSV, either from the collector or the tagger, but more importantly, you can subscribe to a live data feed, which is like a data feed from Twitter, but it has extra annotations, and you can use them for maps, for reports, or for whatever you want. In this case, this is one application that we built using to demonstrate that we can use the output of Aider. It's multilingual in Arabic and English, and it classified tweets related to Syria using Aider and then displays clusters of tweets, time series, et cetera. Again, find me, and I will be happy to do a demonstration for you. Thank you very much.